Customer, we thank you for purchasing new era syringe pump. This particular model is NE 8000. Before that, we have sold a lot of syringe pumps. Normally, those are called NE 1000 series. There are two or three basic differences between NE 1000 series and this NE 8000 pump. This is called a high pressure pump. The reason is that where any 1000 gives a maximum pressure, pressure of 35, force of 35 MPS, this any 8000 gives a maximum force of 2000 MPS. So this can give almost 6 times more force or pressure. The two, three important differences between any 1000 and any 8000 are, firstly, you will see that this is an extra knob in any 8000. In this, you can adjust the force. So on the anti-clock, this is minimal. And if you will rotate it clockwise, it increases the force limit to the maximum. So if you are using very viscous solution, you can increase the force actually. Normally, I would keep it in the middle. Second difference between this pump and any 1000 models are that any 1000 models operate on 12 volt DC. But here you can see that because this is a high force pump, it takes more power and this operates at 12 volt DC. And the third difference is that in the pusher block in any 1000 series, there was one drive nut, and after pressing the drive nut, you can move this pusher block back and forth manually. But in this one, you will have to move this pusher block with the help of the purge function only, which we will discuss very soon. So here we are trying to give a small demo how to run the machine once you get your machine in the lab. And the first thing we will do is we will fix up the syringe. So I'm going from the beginning. So this is our power. This is coming to the 24 volt DC adapter. And here is the 24 volt pin. And this is the on off switch. So firstly, I'm putting the power on. So once you put the power on, you see that these digits are flashing. Press any key and this will stop. So the next thing I'm doing is I'm loading the syringe. In the syringe, this is called the barrel flange and this is called the plunger flange. So you can see that one groove is this one and one groove is here. So in this, the barrel flange will come. And on the back groove, the plunger flange will come. So you can see that if this distance is more in this pump, we will have to purge it and we have to move it back actually. So what we will do, we will put it in the reverse direction and we will keep the start machine pressed. So you can see that the pusher block is moving back. Now our distance is almost appropriate, little bit we can adjust by pressing, so it's more or less fine. Okay. So you have to tighten these two flanges. To tighten this, you can loosen or tighten from here. So I will tighten one nut and from the other side I will tighten the second nut. Now, this is a syringe locking device. You pull it up, twist it, and lock it like this. And you can tighten this also. So, we have tightened this also. And now we have to tighten the plunger flange also. For tightening, you have to rotate it anti-clockwise and it will be tightened. Don't over tighten, otherwise this clip may come out sometimes. So you can see that we have tightened the barrel flange, plunger flange, and we have locked the syringe. There you can see that these are two end point nuts. We can fix the end points, like these are the safety nuts basically. So if we want that our pusher block should not move beyond this, so we can tighten this so that in the end it should never hit by mistake the end point. Again, loosen it and put it where you want exactly, and then tighten it. Hand tight is enough. So now this is not moving, so it will stop the pusher block to hit the end. Please take care, because the force in this machine is too much. So especially if you are using the glass syringes, make sure that whatever volume you have to dispense, it should be between these two limits only. Otherwise it will hit it and your syringe may break actually. Now we are coming to the operation. You can see that these are four arrow keys, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is rate, volume, diameter, back and forth arrow. This decides whether it has to infuse or withdraw. If you will press this, it has come to infusion mode. If you will press it once again, it has come to the withdraw. So it will withdraw. And this is the start and stop. If you will hold the start and stop for a longer time in the withdraw mode, it will do the purging function, and if you will release, it will stop immediately. Okay, so let us do one thing. The first important thing that we have to do is we have to give the diameter of the syringe, because with the diameter of the syringe only the pump knows that what should be the speed to give the correct volume, or we can say it calibrates the volume with the help of the diameter only. So this is our BD syringe of 60 ml. If you will, so here if you will, you will get one chart actually. So if you will see that different make of syringes are there, and according to the volume, there is some diameter. So here we are using BD 60 ml syringe. So diameter is 26.59 mm, and here the maximum flow for this syringe is 166.6 ml per minute and the minimal is 55.47 microliter per hour. So we have to fix the flow in between the minimal and the maximum. And the ID that we have to feed is 26.59 ml. So let's go to ID first, diameter. It's already 26.59. If it is not, so each arrow corresponds to one digit. So if you will push, it will go to 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0, 1, 2. Same way you can adjust or you can fix the value of any of the digits. 26.5. One good thing is if you have to move this arrow, then keep any key pressed continuously and you will see that then arrow will move. See, arrow is moving at the desired position. I have released the key. So I have to give 26.59 is the ID. Now for example, I am giving say a rate of 5 ml per minute and I will give a volume of say 10 ml. So if I go to rate, you can select in different ways. Say now it is ml per minute. If you want to change the unit, press it once again
and see these keys are flashing and press the right key, so micro liter per minute. Now ml per hour, microliter per hour, microliter per minute. So I leave it here, and now I will fix my rate. So I want to give a rate of 5 ml. So how we can give, let's see. Firstly, I will bring this arrow to the center. Now I will make it 5. 4, 5, and now I will make this 0, 0, 9, 0. So now my rate is 5 ml per minute. Now I will give the volume. Volume is 20 ml already. Let's make it 15 ml. 7, 8, 9, 0, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So let's see the parameters. Diameter is 26.59 mm. Rate is 5.00 ml per minute. Volume is 15 ml. So everything is set now, and we can just press the start, so it will infuse the volume. I'm pressing the start. If you want to see that how much volume it has dispensed, you press the volume key and this LED will glow volume dispense, and it will show how much volume is dispensed. So you can see that now 1.3, 1.4, this much of volume is already dispensed. Okay, this is in the withdrawal mode actually. I'm stopping it for a moment. I will make it in the infusion mode and then I will stop. So the volume dispense it is showing. So after dispensing 15 ml, the machine will stop. So make sure that whatever volume you are dispensing, it should end before hitting this position. Otherwise, especially for the glass syringes, it may hit and damage your and break your syringes. We do hope that this video will help you definitely in operating the machine. And we thank you very much for purchasing the new era syringe pump from Unigenetics. If you have any problem anytime, you please feel free to contact us. Thank you very much.